Hi, so I'm really excited about sharing some research that I, along with two colleagues in the Department of Family Preventive Medicine, Lily Gu and Ferris Qeadan, are working on, looking at sex differences in subjective cognitive decline. So some prior research has indicated that at least 35% of dementia risk is amenable to prevention. But whether risk differs between men and women has not been fully explored, nor has sex differences in regards to a more mild form of cognitive impairment, such as subjective cognitive decline. So our objective was to estimate the population attributable fraction of potentially modifiable risk factors for subjective cognitive decline with a focus on sex differences. So methods, we had data from respondents 45 years and older who completed the BRFSS or Behavioral Risk Factor Surveillance System cognitive decline module between 2015 and 2018. Subjective cognitive decline was assessed as answering yes to experiencing confusion or memory loss that is happening more often or is getting worse in the last 12 months. We calculated the population attributable fractions or PAS stratified by sex of the nine known modifiable risk factors that I showed in the previous slide, accounting for the complex survey design, so they were weighted PAS. So in regards to our result, we had a little bit over 216,000 respondents included in this sample, slightly more females at 54% than males at 46%, but with similar reporting of subjective cognitive decline at about 10%, so 10.6% for women and 11.2% prevalence for men. One of the most interesting, more descriptive aspects of this is the age at which this subjective cognitive decline was reported. As you can see on the right, among males, you pretty much have a linear relationship with increasing age and report of subjective cognitive decline. But on the women, you have more of this S-shaped relationship, so that you find that around those menopausal years, women have this higher reporting or probability of reporting subjective cognitive decline, and then it dips down lower. So it's actually lowest at the ages of 65 to 69, and then we have this basic linear rise similar to men. However, getting to the main findings of what makes up, what contributes to potential subjective cognitive decline, we find that nearly 50% of subjective cognitive decline can be attributed to these modifiable factors. Depression was the most significant one, 14% overall, but slightly different with more of that 15% for women compared to 13.9% for men. Other differences that we saw was in deafness, about 4% for women compared to about 7% for men in regards to its contribution to subjective cognitive decline. Obesity, with more women reporting that as, or at least that it was assessed as a contributing factor compared to men. And then finally, this is one of the starkest differences we had in hypertension being a contributing factor for 11.2% PAF for men compared to 7.9% for women. So in conclusion, we found nearly 50% of subjective cognitive decline may be amenable to prevention. Prevalence of subjective cognitive decline is similar between men and women, but there are slight differences in risk factors, notably depression, deafness, obesity, and hypertension, with hypertension and deafness making up more of the contribution for men, and depression and obesity making up more of the contribution for women. However, we need to still run these analyses for adjustments. And one of these really interesting things that we still want to explore is this idea of age of onset or of reporting of subjective cognitive decline and this difference between men and women. So thank you. Certainly happy to answer any questions via email or on through my Twitter handle. Thanks.